The music we are about to share is representative of this period in French music, which we call the period of the clavecinistes, or the harpsichordists, as you know. Louis Couperin was the uncle of François Couperin, but as Louis Couperin died rather young, they actually never met. It's very strange, but we think of the two Couperins as very related. Of course they were very related. But as it was, Louis Couperin died 8 years before François Couperin was born. And he never got to publish his pieces. And the pieces that exist now, so far, are copies of his manuscript by friends and colleagues in Paris. And they're very good, but they need some corrections at the time. The characteristic of Louis Couperin is his wonderful prelude on mystery, unmeasured prelude, where you have to find out what kind of rhythm this is actually going, as it is not written in the music itself, which is challenging and fine. With François Couperin's monumental Eighth Order, we face a very ambitious younger Couperin who is publishing his music, and he is very well established in the French Versailles court, and very much part of the scenery, and his pieces are like that, complex, often on the verge of being pompous, but also very poetic and lyrical times, as we shall hear. In between those two works, we will hear a nice suite by Louis Marchand, a less well-known composer, alas, because he was typical of the style, and very competent, and his G minor suite was published in 1706. This is a typical representative of that. He publishes two suites. The one in D minor is long, and the G minor is short. We'll hear that, and I think this is very fitting in the program as such. And I hope you will enjoy it. Thank you very much.
Thank you.